Big Sur's been out for a while now, and I thought that the features are amazing, but there might be some that you didn't know about. In this video, I go through all of those features which I think you should know. One of the biggest things that happened on Big Sur was the control center. Now, one of the features is if you drag something from the control center to the bar at the top, it moves there permanently. And that makes it easy, quick, one-click access for whenever you need it. For example, Bluetooth. Now, you might be thinking, how do I get rid of certain things that are there that I didn't originally put there? Well, it's simple. You just go into System Preferences and click on the Dock and Menu Bar section. Over there, all you've got to do is just select the one you want and remove it. Simple. You can also, from there, add things extra onto the control center. For example, battery. I personally have everything removed except battery, so it has more of a minimalistic design. Now, when resizing windows, it sometimes gets quite annoying if you want to get the size right or have multiple windows in the corners of your screen. So one cool tip is if you double click one of the sides, it pushes it all the way to that end. So you can do this on the right, left, down, up, and corners. There's a small chance that you knew that. However, you might not know this one. So if you hold Option while you drag, what it does is it proportionally resizes the whole window, which makes it a lot easier if you want to keep it the same ratio and just make it smaller. If you have loads of different apps open and you just want to focus on the one you have and hide all the others, normally what you do is click Command H for each single application you want to hide, but there's an even better feature. Do Command Option H instead, and what that does is it removes every other window except the one you've got open. This can be really helpful when you want to just clear out everything that you can see on your screen except the thing you're using. I wouldn't say so much this is a feature of Big Sur, but one really, really nice thing is that they've now updated Safari. They've made it a lot more like Google, and I'll go through how you can customize it. So one of the first things is, in the bottom right corner, you'll see a new icon. If you click on that, you can choose what background you want. I quite like this one. That's not the only thing they have though. They also allow you to add favorites, which was there before, but now you can choose to remove it from the screen. You've also got the options for frequently visited, privacy report, Siri suggestions, reading list, and like I mentioned at the start, the background image. Sometimes I prefer it not to have anything because it just looks a lot more clean. If you have an iPhone, you will most likely know about the new widgets on iOS 14. Well, Big Sur's got the same thing. However, just like iPadOS, you cannot drag these onto the desktop. But they're still in the notification center. Now, you'll easily know how to do it. You just click Edit, add the ones you want to add on. However, there's a tiny little feature which you might not know. And that is simply just right-click on a widget and you get more options. So once you've right-clicked, you'll see that you have these different options. The top one, if it's available, will be to edit the widget, for example, weather. It'll also allow you to change the size easily by changing between small, medium, or large. It also asks you if you want to remove the widget or just edit the widgets. And this makes the Mac have such a better experience. I hope you include this on your Mac, and if you've got any features that I might have missed, leave them down in the comments below. If you enjoyed that video, please leave a like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.